Hi YouTube. I know it's getting to be Christmas, and I really didn't want to make this video. I've been trying to sit on my feelings for the last few days, but I got a letter from one of my girls' school today, and it's kind of put me over the edge. So yeah, this is going to be a rant video, and I'm sorry, but I've got to do it. I want to read you parts of this letter. Dear blank school family, we are all deeply saddened by the tragedy that took place in Newtown, Connecticut. Our thoughts and prayers go out to those families and the entire community as they grieve. Please be assured that we take the safety and security of our students and staff very seriously at blank public schools. I want to remind you that we have systems in place, such as our lobby guard. Do you know what the lobby guard is? I've used the lobby guard. When you're a volunteer, you use the lobby guard. It's basically a glorified name badge machine. You feed your driver's license into it, it spits out a photo ID for you to then wear while you're in the building. Oh, my kids are so much safer with that. And it only costs $60,000. Besides a lobby guard, we have video surveillance to monitor and protect. Okay, I get the monitor part, but how does a surveillance camera protect? Now, even if there were people that were watching with that camera, I don't know if it's manned or if it's just a videotape, but even if there were people watching, they wouldn't be allowed to have any weapons or guns themselves because they're on school property. And we all know public schools are gun-free zones. So what could they do? No, I'm sorry. All they can do is watch. Unless maybe those video cameras are like unmanned drones and they can remotely shoot at the shooters? I don't know. I don't think so. So all those cameras are going to do is record the carnage. We have a school liaison officer from the Blank County Sheriff's Department who is assigned to our district and is in our buildings, keyword buildings, every school day. There are 5 school buildings, not all on the same campus in my girls' school system. And 1 officer. Oh, yeah, they're so safe with that. Our staff and students practice fire, tornado, and lockdown drills throughout the year. You know what a lockdown drill is? I asked my girls, what do you do in a lockdown drill? And they said, oh, well, the teacher locks the door and then makes sure we're all in the room. And if we are, she puts a green paper under the door into the hallway. And then we all line up on the wall on the same side as the door. And then we are very, very quiet. What? You gotta be kidding me. So, anyone walking down the hallway, oh, I don't know, like an armed gunman, looks down and sees a paper slid under a door. That tells him there's people in that locked room. And if he's got a gun of some kind, he can probably take the lock off that door. And he doesn't even have to pray at that point. All he has to do is spray, because she's got all the kids lined up against the wall. Her too. What? You gotta be kidding me. I don't want the teacher up there being very quiet with the kids. I want her getting in her purse and getting her .45 out and standing beside the door waiting for that idiot to come through. In fact, I want everybody who wants to conceal carry in the school and passes the requirements, I want them to be able to, because that's more people that can not only defend themselves, but defend my kids that I entrust them to. Do you think an armed shooter would have gotten to the point of killing 27 people had there been armed people in the building? I don't think so. Somebody would have taken him out way before then. You know, there's been armed shooters that go into police stations. There's a vastly different outcome. Because why? Because there's a bunch of armed people around that can defend themselves. And it's not about the guns. You know they're going to use this to go after the guns. But it's not about the guns any more than it's about the cars in an auto accident causing the accident. Heck, in China, they just had a guy go into a school in China and stab with a knife 23 children. It's not about the weapon used. It's about people's ability to defend themselves. And our legislatures, those fat cat senators and congressmen, whose kids, I'm sure, do not attend a public school, they probably attend a private school, maybe even with an armed bodyguard, depending on how important mommy or daddy is, they have taken away people's ability to defend themselves with these gun-free zones, whether it's a movie theater or a public school or a mall or whatever. And they've turned these people into sitting ducks and our children in the process. I'll be back in a minute. Any legislator who has worked on legislation that creates these gun-free zones, there is blood on your hands. Oh, yes, there is. Because you've taken away people's rights to defend themselves and our children in school. There is blood on your hands just as much as any shooter who has done something like what happened in Newtown. And you know, when are we as citizens and parents going to say no, enough? You know, we have considered homeschooling. But let me tell you right now, that has moved to the front burner. Because what kind of parent or parents would we be sending our kids to a place that cannot keep them safe, where things like this happen? I'm sure the parents in Newtown, Connecticut never thought anything like that would happen in their backyard. And it did. This was not Chicago. This was not Los Angeles. This was not Detroit. This was Main Street, Podunk, USA, where many of us live. And we just have to say, enough. Quit creating these defenseless, target-rich environments for these madmen to go into and have a field day. And you legislators, you're creating these situations. There is blood on your hands. And if you're a parent, I hope you will consider this. I hope you will think about the public schools. Because you know what? What if we refuse to send our kids to places where they can't be kept safe? I don't know. I don't know what the answer is, but I know it's not taking away people's rights to defend themselves and those they're entrusted with. That's all, YouTube.